إن الحمد لله تعالى وحده نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا فإنه من يهده الله تعالى فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم رحمة الله للخلق أجمعين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our qiyam and siyam, our deeds, our a'mal, our du'as, our tasbih and dhikr. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us mercy, inshallah azza wa jal, and to flee all of us from the punishment of the hellfire, and to grant us the companionship of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannatul Firdaus, inshaAllah, Allahumma ameen. Brothers and sisters in Islam, today's reflection, inshaAllah Azza wa Jal, with Surah Al-Mujadala. Surah Al-Mujadala is the first surah in Juz number 28. And Surah Al-Mujadala is presenting to us the story of Al-Dhihar. Al-Dhihar is the Arabic word derived from al-dhahr, meaning back, the back. So al-dhihar was a form of talaq practiced during the time of Jahiliyyah before the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So during the time of Jahiliyyah, if someone wanted to divorce or to utter al-dhihar, he would say to his wife, "Anti alayya ka dhahri ummi." To me, you are like the back of my mother, which means she is completely prohibited from him, or they are forbidden from one another, and she is not his wife anymore. So this was a form of talaq practiced at this time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by his mercy azza wa jal, removed the difficulty of this ummah and allowed this ummah to pay kafara, fidya, expiation, for this statement, and didn't render it as a divorce. So it's not counted as a divorce if the husband pay off the fidya or kafara. Al-Mujadalah or Al-Mujadilah itself means the pleading woman. So the woman had a case to seek advice or to present. So the pleading woman in this surah was السيدة خولة بنت ثعلبة رضي الله عنها. السيدة خولة بنت ثعلبة رضي الله عنها was an extremely eloquent and well-spoken woman. You know, this story teaches us and teaches all women how to deal during the time of difficulties, how to deal with the time of arguments or conflict with husband. So I will let Sayyida Khawla radiallahu anha to talk to us about her story and to tell us what exactly happened. And this story as recorded in Musnad Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah. Sayyida Khawla says, by Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the beginning of Surah Al-Mujadala from ayah number 1 till ayah number 6. In connection with me and Aws ibn Samit. Aws ibn Samit, her husband. She said, he was my husband and had grown old and difficult. قَدْ سَاءَ خُلُقُهُ وَضَجُرُ. You know, become like difficult and pick up any mistake for his wife. So one day he came to me and I argued with him about something and he said, out of anger. So they had a common argument, could happen with any husband or wife. The argument is not mentioned here because it seems was a very small thing, it's not really a big deal. So it was a normal discussion, normal argument, and out of anger he said, "Anti alayya ka dhahri ummi." You are like my mother's back to me, which is a very dangerous statement. So it's completely, he's telling his wife, you are completely haram, forbidden from me, out of anger. So he was so rushed to make this statement. And unfortunately nowadays in our real life, Many, many brothers, many, many husbands, they do the same thing. You know, for any silly mistake or any silly issue or any silly problem or any argument with his wife, they straight away, they utter word of talaq, and then they come later, ask for advice or fatwa or the way out of his difficulty or this problem. And subhanAllah, many years ago, and I came to know about someone who uttered a word of talaq to his wife because their food was salty. You know, his wife put more salt in the food more than he used to eat it. And subhanAllah, I said to myself, for the salt, some salt, you know, for a meal, you know, people are willing to break up this holy relationship. Let us say holy relationship, because this relationship between wife and husband is a mercy and a sharia and worship, you know, commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's not something from me or you, it's a gift from Allah Azza wa Jal. So one man came to Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu. Aws ibn Samit was rushed. You know, he did this and he said to his wife, you are like my mother's back to me. So a similar situation happened during the time of Umar ibn Khattab, but with normal talaq. And the man came to Umar ibn Khattab and he said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, طلقتم رأتي مئة مرة. Look, subhanAllah. The man said, O Amir al-Mu'mineen, I uttered the word of talaq, divorce, 100 times to my wife. And Umar ibn Khattab said to him, طلقت منك بثلاث وتعذب بالباقي في النار. She is divorced from you. By the third time you utter talaq, and you will be punished with the rest in the hellfire. You will be punished with the rest in the hellfire. So 97 times he will pay them off, and he will be punished, wal'iyadu billah, in the hellfire. So this is very serious matter. Very, very serious matter, subhanAllah. So we have to be careful. So this story is teaching us a lot of advices and a lot of guidance to brothers and to sisters as well. So Aws ibn Samit, after he did and he said what he said, he went out. And, you know, he had some time with his friends, with his people, and came back after an hour, as she said. Then he came back and wanted to have, ثُمَّ هُوَ يُرِيدُنِي عَلَى نَفْسِي. He wanted to have sexual intercourse with me without my wishes. And I said to him, لَا وَاللَّهِ لَا تَخْلُصُ إِلَيَّ حتى يحكم الله ورسوله بيننا بحكمه. By Allah, you will not have your way with me after you said what you said until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam issue judgment about our case. Look, this is the wise woman. You know, she had doubt about something, and then straight away she tries to find out what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam guided us to do in such situation. And this is the way of the righteous woman always. Try to make the Quran and the Sunnah is your reference. Inshallah, you will find all what you wish in the Quran and the Sunnah, inshallah, azza wa jal. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look after you. And Allah looks after you already. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam takes care of your need and your emotion and your heart, because uttering the word of talaq is breaking the heart of the woman. And once you break the heart of your wife, it's very, very difficult to fix it. It takes very long time. So he wanted to have his way regardless of my choice, and I pushed him away from me, and he was an old man. So she overcome him because he was weak because of his age. فغلبته لأنه شيخ ضعيف. So the next thing, she went out to her neighbor and she borrowed like a garment or thiyab from her. And then she went to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She pleaded the case of her husband Zihar before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So she presented her case to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she said, Ya Rasulullah, my husband has consumed my youth. أكل شبابي ونثرت له بطني حتى كبرت سني. So my husband has consumed my youth, and I have given birth to his children, and I have served him all my life. And now I am an old woman. My children have left me. He has carried out dhihar on me or with me. So look at her words, subhanAllah. أكل شبابي ونثرت له بطني. So I give him all my life, my youth, my children. You know, I looked very well after him. So if my small children, that she's trying to explain now the dangerous of the situation, and she's explaining now what is after, and she's giving to Rasulullah ﷺ the choices. She said, if my small children are left with me, they would die of starvation because I can't support them financially. So there is no way I can keep them with me by myself. And if they are left with my husband, they would be destroyed. He cannot look after them. He's an old man, and also because of his attitudes and behavior, so he cannot really look after them. So if the family relation are broken, the children will be the victims. I cannot look after them by myself financially, or he cannot support them as well. So as she was saying this, she raised her eyes to the heaven, and she complained to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And she made dua to Allah azza wa jal. She said, Oh Allah, I plead my case before you. Reveal a command to your Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so that my difficulty is elevated. So she wanted Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to answer her dua. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, she wanted Allah's involvement and Allah's wahi in her story. So subhanallah, al-Quran nazala qabla an tarhal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayat before she left her place, or before she went out of the room. So Imam Ahmad recorded in another narration, Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha said, Alhamdulillah, alladhi sami'a al-mar'a min fawqi sab'i samawat. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who hears all voices. The woman who disputed came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and argued with him while he was sitting in the part of the room. Sayyidah Aisha was sitting in the same room, but in some part of the room. And the woman, Khawla, was speaking to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Aisha didn't hear anything. Didn't hear about her story. How did Aisha find about her story? She was in the same room. She found out about her story from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when the ayah was revealed, when Surah Al-Mujadala was revealed. And she said, subhanallah, I was unable to hear what she said. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exalted, revealed from the seven heaven the ayat. And this is why Aisha radiallahu anha found out straight away and said, subhanallah, subhanallah, الذي يسمع الأصوات. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayah, قَدْ سَمِعَ اللَّهُ قَوْلَ الَّتِي تُجَادِلُكَ فِي زَوْجِهَا وَتَشْتَكِي إِلَى اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ يَسْمَعُ تَحَاورَكُمَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ بَصِيرٌ. Allah had certainly heard the speech of the lady who debated and argued with you concerning her husband, and who complained to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So she argued with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she made a case front of him, and she complained to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَاللَّهُ يَسْمَعُ تَحَاورَكُمَا. Aisha didn't hear your discussion with her, but Allah was listening to your discussion. Verily Allah is all hearing, all seeing. And this is a very strong message to us as well. During the time of conflict between you and your wife, during the time of conflict between you and your husband, remember one thing. إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ بَصِيرٌ. Remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears your discussion. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees your action, your attitudes. So we need to remember this, inshaAllah azza wa jal. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then addressed Khawla bint Tha'labah, saying, إن ابن عمك شيخ كبير فاتق الله فيه. Your cousin, your husband is an old man, so fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with regard to him. So it means exercise patience with him and look for a way to take care of him. So this statement of dhihar, as I said, was practiced before, but Sayyidina Aws ibn Samit, he was the first Muslim after the message to utter this dhihar, or to bring this case to the society, to the Muslim society. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayat to clarify al-dhihar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Allah give the judgment straight away and give the options and give the hukm. The sharia here is saying, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Khawla, told her straight away to inform her husband that he would have to ya'tiq raqaba, so to flee a slave in expiation of fidya of his act of dhihar. Look at the righteous woman. She said, how come he's a poor man? You know, he's not able, oh Rasulullah, he's unable to give, to pay this kind of ransom or fidya. Rasulullah ﷺ then gave her the other choice with revealed in the Quran. صِيَامُ شَهْرَيْنِ مُتَتَابِعَيْنِ, to fast for two consecutive months. And she said, you know, he's an old man. He has a health condition. He cannot do so. Look at the wise and really, you know, righteous woman. Instead of complaining, not only complaining about her husband, she was looking for a way out for her husband. Not only for herself. She was supporting her husband even in this difficult time. She could take advantage of the situation and she could make a stronger case against her husband and in favor for her. But subhanAllah, she was also supporting him in this difficult time. And she said, Ya Rasulullah, he cannot fast. He's an old man. And Rasulullah says, the ayat after, or the option after, إِطْعَامُ سِتِّينَ مِسْكِينَ, he should then feed 60 poor people, provide like two meals for 60 needy people. The woman said, you know, financially he is a poor man, he doesn't have enough. And she said to the Prophet Muhammad, he's not able to feed all of his family in such way. You know, he cannot even provide maybe like two meals or three meals for his family. How can he provide like this for 60 miskeen? Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the merciful, the gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, says he would offer and he would assist by supplying some dates. So Rasulullah sallallahu would give some dates and then Aws ibn Samit will give it as a charity, as a sadaqah. And this is the wisdom behind unity within the community. So looking after each other is not only, you know, by making du'as or just even giving some support to each other. Helping each other is to bring us back to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasulullah sallallahu was removing the difficulties and was removing the, let me say, the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it'am sittin miskina, you know, was feeding 60 people. It was like a punishment for him, because he wasn't able to do so. If Rasulullah ﷺ said, no, this is the only way, yeah, then he would stuck. If the siyam, fasting 2 months, was the only way, the man would, you know, stuck. So Rasulullah ﷺ, out of his mercy, ﷺ, he offered some assistance and some help. And this is the way we should deal with each other, inshallah, azza wa jal. Khawla then, she said, I would do the same thing. You know, she would also supply some dates to assist her husband, radiallahu anha. So then Rasulullah ﷺ praised her action. Praised her action. And whenever Rasulullah ﷺ praised someone's action, is like a dua. And he said to her, أصبتي وأحسنتي فاذهبي فتصدقي عنه. So you have done well. Go and give this charity towards him. ثم استوصي بابن عمك خيرا, and treat him kindly, and treat him kindly. Rasulullah sallam didn't say, if he does it again, come back and I will do this and that, will punish him and you will take you away from him. No, as many people do. as many families do, when they make reconciliation between the families, we need to be wise. Like Rasulullah SAW, he said, ثُمَّ اسْتَوْصِي بِابْنِ عَمِّكِ خَيْرًا, and be kind and nice to your cousin and your husband. So Khawla radiallahu anha was such a distinguished woman in Islamic history. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded to her straight away, and Allah azza wa jal answered her dua. And our ummah, since that time till the day of judgment, will always remember her as long as the Quran is recited. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu once was riding his camel or his donkey and walking, and an old lady stopped him and she called him, Umar, ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, I want to talk to you. Then Umar ibn al-Khattab get off of his donkey or camel and he stopped to speak to her. Khalifa, ruler of the Muslim Ummah, big armies, you know, under his command. And then his companions and his friends, they said, how can you stop for an old lady? You don't have time for this. You don't have time. And Umar radiallahu anhu says, you know, don't you know who this lady is? أَلَا تَرَوْنَا أَلَا تَعْلَمُونَ مَنْ هِيَ هَذِهِ الْمَرْأَى. Don't you know who is this lady is? هِيَ الْمَرْأَى الَّتِي سَمِعَ اللَّهُ صَوْتَهَا مِنْ فَوْقِ سَبْعِ سَمَاوَاتِ. She is the lady Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heard her voice and listened to her dua and listened to her request from the above heavens, from above the seven heavens. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listened to her. كيف لي أن أسمع ألا أسمع شكواها. How come if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listened to her complaint and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listened to her voice, how come Umar ibn al-Khattab doesn't listen to her or hear her complaint? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did, Allah Azza wa Jalla concluded this beautiful story by saying, ذَلِكُمْ تُوعَظُونَ بِهِ. اسمعوا هذا الكلام يا إخوان. ذَلِكُمْ تُوعَظُونَ بِهِ. Meaning this is a warning and an advice to threaten you in this case. So be careful. Take this advice. Take this maw'idha. Take this guidance. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all aware of what you do. Pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit all of us from Al-Quran Al-Azim. To pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, to gather all of us with Sayyida Khawla bint Tha'laba and her husband Aws ibn Samit radiallahu anhum fi Jannat al-Firdaws. Allahumma ameen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.